She's assisted by Charles Watson and Angel Kent. And the Aces win the tip with ease. Sutton off the mark from three. She's having a spectacular second season in the WNBA. Jackie Young is not going to miss from there, showing why she's the Aces' leading scorer at nearly 21 points a game. For a second time here at home and for just the third time on the season, Jackie Young earning a trip to the free throw line. Wilson, that turnaround jumper is a thing of beauty. Of course, Wilson joined the 3,000-point scored career club against Connecticut on June 8th.
So she goes, boy, I'm going to be there for one night. We've got a game on Friday, we've got the Hall of Fame on Saturday, and then a game on Sunday.
Gray, three, doesn't miss that time. Jackie Young denied by Turner. Battle for the rebound won by Parker. What a finish. Nikki Blue and Tully Bevilacqua. Jefferson puts it on the deck, beats Stokes at the rim.
I'll do the mama.
Out of the break, a turnover and a finish by Michaela Onyemwere. Jackie Young, three on the way is good. 4 minutes to go here in the first quarter of play. Gray, three, boom.
3-point basket, Chelsea
Gray. Can see Turner and Westbrook really got hooked up.
This is a Commissioner's Cup game, and of course, Chelsea Gray was the Commissioner's Cup MVP. Westbrook with her foot on the line, but the basket is good. Megan Gustafson getting it to Cunningham. Cunningham serving, shot clock into single digits. Jefferson, three, is good. Michaela Onyemwere getting set to check back in. Gustafson, the lefty, trying to defend the lefty Wilson and losing the battle that time.
Yeah, Wilson is just developing.
She plays on both ends of the floor. Clark off on the triple, battle for the rebound, won by who else? Wilson. Jackie Young for three. That's nothing but nets.
Yeah, just very unselfish team right now for the Aces.
Kelsey Plum, a little hezzy, kicks it back out. Plum, corner, three, splash.
She's really stepped up as that scorer for the Phoenix Mercury.
Clark brings it back out. Young, three, good. And you were in your introductory press conference, and you were very intentional about saying, I am the owner of the Mercury and Suns. But what was that atmosphere like for you? Because that was your first experience with the Mercury Live.
You know, it was awesome. You know, seeing the energy in this arena, seeing the fans. I'm more focused on more fans, more eyeballs, more people supporting this team, the Suns, and having a lot of fun with it. I think it's great that everybody, I don't know if it's cable or not cable, I think it's key that everyone has access to all the games. I hate hearing people not be able to see this Mercury, see the Suns, what channels it on. Hopefully the rest of the league follows that everyone has access to all the games. That's how you create fans. That's how you have a lot of fun with it.
That's awesome.
It's been great getting to meet all the other owners, the WNBA and the NBA owners, and seeing the support of each other while we're trying to grow the league, grow the W, grow the NBA, grow both.
So we know that you're still living back in the state of Michigan. So when are you going to make your home here out west with us? We know that you played for Tom Izzo at Michigan State, and you were in school concurrently with Diana Taurasi when she was at UConn. Were you aware of her greatness at that juncture?
Oh, yeah. Was a big fan. Obviously disappointed she's not playing. I hope she'll get healthy and play soon, but
right.
She's one of the best of all time.
100%. She's only 815 points away from 10,000 career. The next closest person doesn't play in the game anymore, Tina Thompson, and she's like 2,500 points clear of her. What does that mean to you?
And they play a lot of minutes, and they also play for years and years. So seeing Candace and Diana and all these players, and then this new young crop of players, it's really exciting for the league. And then at the same time, I love seeing the joy and energy they play with them, just like that, right there. Like,
Megan told me before the game that she's adopting a more back-to-the-basket style as the Mercury get beat on the offensive end there. Megan told me before the game that she's adopting a more back-to-the-basket style as the Mercury get beat on the offensive end there.
Toughness inside. I know we're trying to get in there. I love watching Meg. I love this team, you know.
Yep.
Obviously, we're not up right now, but I'm watching them. I think we have a shot.
When Coach Izzo asked you to sit on the bench with him as a coach?
We learned so much. When you know, as a player, you understand what he's looking for. As a coach, you see the other side of it. You see why he's asking the players, you see why behind. And, you know, I tried to put that in my mortgage business, and the same thing here with the Mercury and the Suns.
What was your biggest failure? Because they know the owner is in the house as well. Before we went to break, we talked about your biggest setback that helped you achieve success today. What was that?
You know, I just think it was, I don't know if it was a setback, but being able to be.
And that's been one of the things that the Mercury have struggled with is setting screens.
Working inside is Wilson. She's got an even dozen to go along with 8 rebounds.
Sometimes, but the point guard was always there, and we were ready to run, and so then everyone was filling their spots. We were, you know, there's a little longer shot clock in college. Back when I played, it was 35 seconds, so we had early offense, we had shot clock play, so, but we were running with the point guard.
Here on Arizona's Family Sports Network, we've got the second half for you of the only game on the WNBA slate today between the defending champion Aces. Alongside the Hall of Famer Ann Myers Drysdale, I'm Cindy Brunson. We're so glad to have you along the way. It is camp day here at the Footprint Center. So tons of kids and a shot opportunity at the free throw line for Chelsea Gray. Sutton escaping Young. 3 on the way by Cunningham. Misses everything. Mick tried to get the basketball and does. Cunningham leaving it for Turner. That's nice. Turner matching her season high with 6 points. A delay of game charge against the Mercury there, so they have to be careful. The next one is a technical foul shot. Candace Parker down low, a mismatch she probably dreams about. Making things dicey for Sophie as she now has 4 personal fouls. Terrific take by Plum. 6.5 minutes to go. Jefferson attacking baseline. What a reverse! Okay, Mo.
One of the first, I think, young coaches, to really use social media to the advantage.
Sophie Cunningham, the hezzy effective.
On any given day. If that makes sense.
It does.
Night and day.
It does. Sutton buries the triple. It's the 9th time in double figures this season. Kelsey Plum cannot be denied. She will make you pay. 5 minutes to go in the 3rd quarter. Nice rebound put back by Sutton. Sutton's got 13. Jackie Young for 3. You betcha.
Shook Sutton handling the ball quite a bit. Looking again. There's a nice little layup going to the basket.
She's got 15 points to lead the Mercury. Megan Gustafson getting set to check in. 4 minutes to go here in the 3rd quarter. Wilson, nothing but the bottom of the net. She is good.
Such an unselfish play by Candace Parker.
Former Mercury player here, now working for Las Vegas.
Yeah, back in 2015 came and played for Sandy Brundell. A nice pass.
Turner gets the roll. So Las Vegas goes back to work on the offensive end. They come into this game.
Another
George with the pass. Yes. Cunningham defended by the much taller Candace Parker. Shot clock into single digits. Nice take by Sophie and an opportunity for a 3-point play the old-fashioned way. So Las Vegas flirting with that with 6.5 minutes to go. They've got 28. Make it 29. Nice find by Plum to George. Wilson attacking lefty on lefty around Gustafson up and in. Sutton, pull-up jumper, off the mark, battle for the rebound, won by Kia Stokes. And that is how this game will end, as the Aces get the victory, 99-79.